Amen.
Amen.
Power. Amen. Amen. Listen, I looked in a book that had words that had meaning attached to it called the dictionary. And I looked at the word power, and the word power is the ability to do something or act in a particular way. The capacity or the ability to direct or influence the behavior of others or cause the course of events. Name is a word or a set of words by which a person, animal, place, or being is known, addressed, or referred to. In the book of Acts, is written by the apostle, the physician Luke. Luke was one that wrote one of the synoptic gospels and then wrote the book of Acts also. And notice in the text, it talks about Peter and John, the close friends. Now, I want to talk about a few things in that third chapter. Is they were on their way. Now, here is a lame man that was born lame. He had become lame, but he was born lame. Now, and he was carried. Now, the Bible didn't say he was carried and laid at the outside or the inside of the gate to the temple. But this man was born lame, and they carried him. Looks like he was expecting, the Bible says he was expecting some fortune. And they laid him at the gate daily. Now, I asked myself a question, why would they take him to the church looking sometimes for their finances? But look like they would carry him to the marketplace, because people that go to the marketplace, they come prepared to buy what they want. Usually when folks come to church, they come to church, they don't mind coming to church. Bro, I ain't better than nobody. But when you go to the store, you know, where people do window shopping years ago, I used to talk about window shopping, but when folks go now, if they don't have the pants, they got plastic. That's just as good, but they carried him to the church. Now, the person that carried him to the church is something in that that they had to have some kind of faith and know and some knowledge of, if I just get it to the church. They didn't just carry him there every once in a while, but the Bible said they carried him daily and laid him at the gate. Now, notice that they carried him and laid him at the gate. And you say, now, why is it that they carried him to the church? Now, those folks that carried him, now this was not a child, this was a grown man that they carried. So you know he had, it took probably more than one of them to carry him. And they were committed to carry him to the church. Now, there's a question that is in my mind, is there anybody that's committed to carry the work of God home? I don't have a problem with church work, but every once in a while, the work of the church ought to be done. They were carrying him and to the church because they knew that he could get some help. Yeah. And this is, and as they carried him and laid him at the gate, the gate called Beautiful, and there was power in the name. And I noticed they carried him during prayer service. They carried him to church. Now, the Jewish folks had three different prayer times. They had 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, and 3 o'clock. In the text, the ninth hour was 3 o'clock. But they carried him to prayer service while prayer was going on. And you know, the thing about it is, when you talk about folks tell you what time the service starts. But can I tell you that prayer is preparation for service. I just want to help him, but I'm going to preach it now. But they carried him during the hour of prayer. Because, listen, when you're in prayer, you won't be just sitting up at the service, but you'll be in the service. Because a lot of times when folks miss out on prayer, and then it is sacrificial service. There's a dark bus that after it's finished its route, it has a marquee on that thing, out of service. I think I need to tell you, you could be sitting up in service, but yet out of service. But they carried him at the gate during the hour of prayer. Listen, he was looking for some help, and because of being lame, it appeared that he had no hope. But finally, one day, as Peter and John were on their way to prayer and to the temple, and they saw this lame man. Now, you see, the blessing of here, Peter and John were close friends. And even though Peter and John, they had brothers that were biologically kin to them, that Jesus called as some of his other disciples. But notice in there that Peter and John were on their way into the temple at the hour of prayer. But the prophet, the blessing of this, Peter was already was dealing with the old folks, was dealing with the apple. You know, in chapter 2, in the book of Acts, it deals with the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. It was that scripture that Peter talked about, and he was on his way with John. Now, can I tell you, Peter and John were familiar with each other. They were not strangers, because Peter and John were the ones who sang too after Jesus had risen from the grave. Went to the tomb of Jesus, and John outran Peter and got up to the grave and looked in. But when Peter got there with John, Peter went inside and looked at the ground of the grave clothes where Jesus had been. So they were familiar with each other, and while they were going up at the hour of prayer, they looked and I want to just, can I just use my pastor's imagination and say they laid him inside at the gate. And the reason I said that they laid him inside the gate, because it didn't say that he was outside the gate, but because when Peter and John said that they went up, this way they went into the gate, but it said when they were on their way up. Listen, it's amazing that sometimes we get to the point that we're on our way up, but we fail to look down. And sometimes we get so caught up in the message until we bypass and miss out on the mission. They were on their way up into the temple at the hour of prayer, and a certain man that was lame from his mother's womb, they carried him, and Peter seeing him, and who seeing Peter and John, the lame man, listen, he was lame, but he still could see. He was lame, but he wasn't dumb. He could still see. He was lame, but he wasn't deaf. I don't have no problem with folks being deaf that don't get deaf. But while he was on his way, the lame man, and you know, being not able to walk, it is suggested almost that I don't know if the lame man was laying on his stomach or was he laying on his back. But as they were going up, they looked and he looked and saw him going up into the temple. And then he asked all of them, "Could I need some money?" But Peter said, "Listen, look on us with John and John." And Peter and John was looking on the lame man, but only Peter spoke up. Because Peter was still under the influence of the apple on the day of Pentecost. He looked and Peter spoke up and said, "Silver and gold have I none. But such," listen, can I tell you, God is a God of purpose, and sometimes he'll leave something no purpose to fulfill his promise. But while he was on his way up, he said, "Now, I want you to understand that silver and gold have I none. But such as I have, give I thee." Now, the man was looking up, but listen, not only was he looking up, but after looking up, he received need to handle. I need to tell you that sometimes in the midst of it all, when it looks like things are not going the way that we feel that it needs to go, we need to learn how to look up. I found out years ago that our hookup is not from looking around, but our hookup is from looking up. I can hear the song and say, I'll look to the hill from which coming my help, from my help coming from the Lord. Can you see this man, and Peter said, children, go and help our son, but nothing I have, give I thee, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rise up! I don't want you to get up. I don't want you to get up. But I want you to get up and walk. Because it wasn't silver and gold. It wasn't a discard card. It wasn't a master card of me. But that was a long name of Jesus. I can hear him say the song. That's a long name. But no name I know. If you're silver and gold, you're dried up. If you're getting this high, they're rolling. Because I know that you need some help, but I got a hand that's been anointed by God. I got some hair that's been blessed in hell. That says you shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. And people reach with my right hand. And lift this lame man up, and the Bible that his elbow received strength. And he stood up. He stood up, and then he began to walk. And when he found out he could walk, he couldn't leave it. He didn't leave the church. But he went right on into the temple with him. Because he had received his healing in the name. Not in Peter's name. Not in John's name. But in the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. No other name I know. The name of Jesus, that power, wonderful living power, in the name of Jesus. And he went to the temple, leaving and praying to God. And somebody said, now what happened to this man? I know he was lame. I know he was lame from his mother's womb. I know they carried to the church. They laid him out dead. Now what happened to the people that he was out there?
I wish I had a man right there. He's from the
Thank you.